Have you ever been to Shake Shack? Shake Shack has some really good burgers, and right now there's an offer for a way for you to get free French fries if you're in New York City. Do you want free fries? Do you really, really want them? Welcome to Escaping the Echo Chamber. So there has been an announcement today that there's a way for us to get free fries at Shake Shack. Are you ready for it? Are you ready for what you have to do to get free fries? It's not a matter of buy something, get the fries free. In order to get free fries, you need to show that you've been vaccinated.
Anytime you go for the next month, you're there grabbing your burger, your chicken sandwich, show us your vaccine card. We'll get you a free fries on us.
So now, if you're an individual that has chosen not to take the vaccine because you think, wait a minute, this hasn't been fully tested. It's just experimentally being approved. And that's what is the provisionally approved? Because it hasn't gotten 100%, it hasn't gotten official approval. It's been like a temporary approval from the FDA. But if you're of the mind that I'm not sure if this stuff is safe, I don't think it's a significant enough risk. The disease is a significant enough risk to me to take the risk of taking the vaccine. Or you say, hey, I already had the disease. I recovered. I should be good. Whatever your reasons are, there are people, including the mayor of New York City, who think they can convince you to now go ahead and get the vaccine for free French fries. These people are running the government. Do you get that? These people are in charge of the government. These people run everything we see around us. That's why we're fucked. That's why we're fucked. Because these idiots are in charge.
Randy, thank you to the whole Shake Shack team. This is really going to help us out. And did you say free fries when you get vaccinated? I got vaccinated. You're saying I could get this? The delicious fries. Wait a minute. But there's also a burger element to this. But if this is appealing to you, just think of this when you think of vaccination. Vaccination. I'm getting a very good feeling about vaccination right this moment. Thank you to Randy Garrudi. And of course, Danny Meyer is doing so much to help us with the recovery and the entire team. I've got to finish chewing for a moment. I think that would be more dignified, don't you think? Yeah.
So this display from de Blasio was just utterly ridiculous. You know what it reminds me of? Do you remember Married with Children? There was an episode with Married with Children where Kelly's doing commercials, and apparently the stuff is just really disgusting. But what she's got to do is she's got to drink the stuff, say, tasty, and then say the name of the flavor. And like they had just some ridiculous, like, I'm trying to remember what some of the flavors were, but like I remember one of the flavors, she goes, tasty cow pie. That was more convincing and less nauseating than what de Blasio did. And like perhaps he should have like rehearsed this before doing this, and somebody could have said to him, yeah, let's not do this. Let's just let the CEO make the announcement, you show the French fries, and then you don't eat the French fries. Let's do it that way. But anyway, I mean, it's just the absurdity of what's going on and the lengths they're going to try to convince us to take the vaccine. Like, listen, calm down. Let people who want to take it, and let other people who don't just do what they do. The people who feel at risk, who feel worried, they'll be safe. The other people will be at risk, okay, let it be. Like, that's life. That's what happens. People get to make personal choices, and people get to choose their own acceptable level of risk. That's been a public service announcement from Escaping the Echo Chamber. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe. Like right now, Shake Shack sales have probably gone down thanks to you, Mr. Mayor. Thanks to you, de Blasio. And people may think it's the vaccine, his support for the vaccine, but no, it was just that disgusting display of it was disgusting, and it was just stupid. It was stupid as hell. And the notion that people who don't want to get the vaccine, who haven't got the vaccine, will suddenly say, ah, but those free fries. I mean, it really is absurd. It's beyond absurd. And then you've got like some, is it either mayor or governor in another city that's doing a lottery. Like you could win money if you take the vaccine. It's like, wow, y'all are really trying to convince people. Like y'all are, I have to at least say, at least it's the carrot, not the stick right now. I think the stick is coming, but at least it's the carrot, not the stick, but it's still, they really look really ridiculous right now. And then the latest, of course, oh, if you have the vaccine, you don't have to wear the mask. Like, that really should have been obvious already. Like, what's the point of getting the vaccine if I still need to wear the mask? Like, I should be safe, right? Like, cause that's the purpose. That's what you're claiming the vaccine does. It makes me safe. It protects me from getting the disease. Like, never mind trusting the science, trust the logic. Like, the logic says, if the vaccine is going to stop me from getting the disease, wow, I don't need this mask anymore. Correction, I don't need this fashion accessory. We haven't been wearing masks. And that's why the numbers are what they are. But nonetheless, we're at a point of just peak ridiculousness of, and it's like, do we have any hope? If this is what our leaders, if this is the best our leaders can do, well, number one, we need new leaders. Number two, we need to start looking at ourselves about our choices, because clearly our choices of leadership have much to be desired. If you enjoy this content, give me a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe. And if you're somebody who is not a fan of these clowns we have in charge, subscribe to the channel, because I'm not a fan of them either. I'm not a fan of them either. Of course, if you are a fan of them and you voted for them and you're like, I don't like you criticizing my choices, give me a thumbs down. Give me a thumbs down. But don't give me a thumbs down and run away. Give me a thumbs down and say why in the comment section. I'll address it either in the comment section or in a future video. I'll see you next time. Have you ever been to Shake Shack? Listen, you may have had McDonald's, you may have had Burger King. They don't compare. Five Guys, that's somewhat comparable. But if you go to Shake Shack, they have actual burgers with actual beef. They are really good. I've been on a diet lately, so I'm missing Shake Shack, but I'm telling you, Shake Shack burgers are really, really, really good. And their fries aren't bad. They've got these loaded fries that are pretty good, but the regular fries are okay. Do you want to know how you can get free fries at Shake Shack? Do you really want to know? Welcome to Escaping the Echo Chamber.